children, how are you? I hope you must be good and keep taking care of yourself. Now today in this video I will be teaching you the last chapter of Robinson Crusoe for the half yearly. That is chapter number 6. Man Friday. Right. Friday is not the name of a day, but it is the name of a person. Right. Now we'll see how Robinson Crusoe came across this man Friday, and how the name had been given to him Friday. Right. Now in the previous class, previous chapter, chapter number 5, we had learned that while he was roaming about, exploring in the island, when he came across some skull and bones of a man. Then he found he was very scared, and then he came to know that people come on this island, this carnival, and they bring man and they come and eat. So he was very scared that they might come to know that in this island he was staying, and they would eat his goat which he had collected, and him also. So he tried to keep away as far as possible from them, from their views, and from his looking glass. Now looking glass is a type of a telescope, old fashioned. And during the during those times, the telescope was different. It was straight, right? And they used to adjust, not which we get in recent, which we see in recent time, right? So then he comes across that in the island once again these carnivals had come, and they had come with this man, and this man tried to escape, and he comes across he comes on his way in front of Robinson Crusoe, and he decided to save this man, and hence he shooted those carnivals, those tribal people, and some ran away they were scared. So now this carnival, this man who was trying to run away, since he was found on the day Friday, Robinson Crusoe named him Friday. He used to call that man Friday, and he kept him, he took him as his companion, or you can say as his servant. And since this man was also grateful that Robinson Crusoe had saved his life from these tribal people, he obediently obeyed to whatever he was told by him. Now let's read the chapter. Now we'll open to chapter number 6, that is page number 30. Now as I told you, carnivals are what? A person who eats flesh of other people. And looking glass is what? A small telescope. Now 3 years has passed. He had been staying in that island, not coming in front of those tribal people, and he spent in that island for the 3 years. I had almost stopped dreaming about the carnivals when early one morning I saw no less than 5 empty canoes on my side of the island. Now for 3 years he never saw them, and he also avoided coming in front of them. So he thought the fear of the carnivals, the tribal people, had vanished, right? But one day, one early morning, when he got up from his sleep, what he saw, that there were 3 canoes. Canoes are what? Canoes are the small boat made out of the log of wood, right? So there were 5. How many canoes there were? 5 canoes. It was empty, and they were standing on the on the side of the island. Where have they gone? I wondered. Wondered means he was getting thinking. There must be at least 30 of them. Now he is visualizing. Now 5 canoes. That means how many people it might be. So he visualized that it was. It might be 30 people might have come to that island. I got my guns ready at my castle and waited for an attack, but none came. I climbed the hill with my spyglass and looked down at the shore. There were at least 30 men dancing across the fire. Now what he did? Now he decided to go and see. So he went to his castle. Castle is he used to call where he stayed. He had built his house in the beginning. He called that place his castle. Now in that castle he went inside and got ready with the gun and gunpowders, and then he took out his spyglass, the looking glass, right? So he took out the telescope and he started looking at searching the people where they had gone, and then he saw that there were about 30 people dancing around the fire, right? They were dancing around the fire. As I watched means as he was looking, I saw 2 miserable prisoners being dragged from one of the canoes. One of them was hit with a spear and he fell to the ground. 3 carnivores immediately cut him up ready for their cookery. Now what he saw, that 2 miserable means helpless. Miserable means helpless. Prisoners, those who have committed mistake and they were prisoned. So now they had brought 2 people and they were dragged out from the canoe. And one of them, while they were dragging, one of the tribal people, what he did, he poked his spear. Spear is a weapon made, as I told you in the beginning of my video, spear is a is a weapon which they use for killing people and animals. Now he poked him into his body and he immediately fell down and he died. Then 3 of the carnival people, tribal people, they came running and they cut him into pieces, and they they got him ready, brought him near the fire, poked inside the twig, and got ready to be cooked. Cookery means to be cooked. The other victim stood still for a moment watching. The other person was, he was standing still but without moving about. He was you can imagine that his friend was killed in front of him and they were cut into pieces and they were going to cook him. And he was standing over there and visualizing, now next turn is mine. If their hunger does not satisfy them, they are going to kill me and make me their food. So he was helplessly standing and watching those people. Then I seized my chance. Seized means grabbed. My chance, he grabbed their chance and ran with amazing speed. Amazing speed. Unbelievable speed he ran in the direction to his house. Why? Because he was terrified. Terrified means scared. He was very scared. Now my nightmare will come true, I gasped. The others will follow him. They will discover me. Now why? Ran towards his house because his nightmare, when he came for at first when he came to know that these people come, these cannibal people come, and he saw them eating, killing people and eating. Now he was very terrified that these people will come to know about me, and they will also kill me and cut me, and then they will make him his food. So like he was gasping, he was taking big heavy breath. Now I felt happier when I saw the other saw that only two or three men ran after him, and soon they lost him because he ran so swiftly. Suddenly a thought came to me. Then again he watched from his looking glass. What he saw that the man who the other prisoner who was standing miserably and watching them eating his friend. So what he did, when he got the chance, that person, he quickly ran towards the forest, and two or three people ran after him. Two or three tribal people, they ran after him to catch hold of him, and soon they lost him. Then suddenly, all of a sudden, an idea came to him. This man might be a companion for me or a servant. I must save his life. I ran as far as I could towards the victim and placed myself between him and his attacker. Attacker is the person, the two or three cannibal people who was running after him to kill him. So what he did, what was the thought that came to him? The thought that came to Robinson Crusoe's mind, that this man who the victim, the man who ran towards the forest, that if he save him, he could be his companion or his servant. Right, companion is a friend. So he would get someone to talk to in this lonely island. So what he did, he ran as fast as he could towards the direction of the victim and the tribal man who were chasing him. And all of a sudden, like he came between the attacker and that victim, and he hold like what he did. Now next we'll see what he did in the next paragraph, page number 31. Now the victim, he came in between the attacker and the victim, and he shooted him. Because why Robinson Crusoe shooted the attacker? Because he had raised his bow and arrow to kill him. If he had not shot him with his gun, then surely the attacker would have killed Robinson Crusoe. So now the poor victim was so frightened. Frightened means he was scared. Right. He was scared. Why he was scared? By the noise and the fire of my gun, that he completely stood still. Now on those time, people were very less people knew about the gun, and those who had gun, so people they were very scared of those people who had guns with them. Right, come here, I said again. Come here, I shall not hurt you. He walked a little way, then stopped, trembling, as if I had taken him prisoner again and was about to kill him. He came forward again and knelt every 10 or 12 steps to thank me for saving his life. When he reached me, he kissed the ground, lifted my foot and placed it on his head. Now, what did this gentleman, victim, like what he did? He was trembling. Trembling means shaking out of he was shaking out of fear, shaking out of fear. So what he did, like as he was coming towards, first this thing, first thought it came to him that once again he became the prisoner, and he would surely like those carnival, this thing, Robinson Crusoe would also make him a prisoner, and he would also kill him and make him his food. So as he, but he has no other alternative. So he, as he was coming forward, after every 10 to 12 step he was taking, what he did, he kissed the ground. He kissed the ground to give a signal to that other man that that he had, he is thankful for saving his life. So every 10 to 12 steps he was kissing the ground. And finally, when he came near to Robinson Crusoe, he lifted his leg and he kept his on top of his head. Now, on keeping on top of his head signifies that he would he is thankful and he would stay under him, like he would be his servant. Don't kill him, right? As he did this, the man I had knocked means threw down the person to the ground, got up. I spoke to the man at my feet, and he answered. I could not understand his word, but I thought they were pleasant to hear. Why they were pleasant to hear? Because he had not heard for a long time, for many years he had not heard a voice of a person. And although he was not, Robinson Crusoe could not understand what that gentleman was talking, because he was talking in his own native language, tribal language. But he was happy to hear his voice, because after all it is a man's voice, it's a human being's voice, and he had not heard this the human being's voice for a pretty long time, right? But I thought they were pleasant to hear, for they were the first sound of a man's voice that I had heard for 25 years. So he had stayed there for how many years? 25 years. For 25 years he had not heard any man's voice, right? But he had heard one voice. What was that? The voice of his parrot. With one clean stroke, he cut off his head, head of the carnival, and placed it at my feet along with my sword. I turned to go, pointing towards the cave. Come with me, I told him. Now what he did, he picked up the sword and at one strike, like he cut the carnival's head and put the head in front of his feet. That means he thought that this man also, like Robinson Crusoe, also eats man's flesh like the carnivals. So in one way he was indicating to him the whole whole three of the carnival is there, his. He can have it, he can keep it, he can eat it. But Robinson Crusoe was not that sort of a person. He never ate man. So what he did, he moved away, moved away, and he pointed him to come towards his cave where he was staying. He shook his head and pointed to the bodies on the ground. Then in the direction of the kennels, I made a digging movement with my hand, and he set to work burying both the bodies in 15 minutes. Now, why the victim shook his head when Robinson Crusoe pointed him to come towards towards his cave, he pointed his head no, he shook his head no. Why? and then what Robinson Crusoe still never understood. Then he pointed towards the empty canoe. Now, why did he point it towards the empty canoe? Because he wanted to tell him that only two people have been killed, but there are 30 people. So 28 people are still there waiting for him to bring him. So to remove the so it is better to remove the evidence. So remove this cannibals. So what then Robinson Crusoe also thought, yes, he's right. Then what he did, he with a sign language, since they never understood each other's their language. So with a sign language, he said to dug the floor, ground. And then within 15 minutes, victim, he dug the ground. And he put both the victor, attacker inside and covered it up. He buried them, right, within 15 minutes. Then I took him to my cave. The young man I had saved was a handsome fellow. Now, then Robinson Crusoe, what he did with that man, he took him to his cave. And then what he noticed that the victim was a young man. The victim was what? A young man, and he was a handsome, means good looking person. He was tall and well shaped. So that he's describing that victim. He was handsome, good looking. He was tall, well shaped, means like he had a good physique. His hair was long and black. His skin olive. His face round and plump. I looked gentle and kind. He looked gentle and kind. So he described the victim as a gentle and a kind person. I shall call you Friday, I told him, for today is Friday. So I shall call you Friday, and he shall call him what? Master. So now when they were going back to when they reached the cave, and observing that victim thoroughly, Robinson Crusoe decided to give him a name, and that is Friday. Why Friday? Because he found him on Friday. He met him on Friday, and he told him that you are going to call me Master, right? I also taught him to say yes and no, and their meaning. So the first language, the name was introduced, it was taught, and then he taught him to say yes and no, and when to say. So he made him understand the meaning of yes and no. Right. I showed him how to drink milk from a bowl. I gave him clothes to wear. The next day we went down to the shore to make sure that the carnivals had gone. As we were walking past the buried bodies of the savage, Friday knelt down and dug in the sand. He put his hand to his mouth. I was horrified. Horrified means fully angry, right? So Robinson Crusoe taught him. Robinson Crusoe taught Friday his name, the meaning of yes and no, then how to drink milk from a bowl, right? And then he also taught him how to wear clothes, because cannibal people usually stay naked, right? They don't put on any clothes like us. And the next day when they were walking down the shore, bank of the sea, so they to make sure that whether those people that had 28 cannibals who were still waiting, whether they had gone or not. After they were assured that they had gone, they walked past to that same place where they had buried the savage, right? So what Friday did, he quickly ran toward that ground, that place, and he removed the mud and he brought his this thing, took out that man, and he was going to eat that cannibal, that attacker. Robinson Crusoe was very, very angry, horrified, meant horrified that he could not believe. He could not believe that such a thing can happen, that after like one day stale food he was going to eat, and that too a flesh of a man, right? I shouted, "No, no, we don't eat men." There was no sign of cannibals or their canoes, but once again I gazed in horror at the sight that met my eyes on the beach. Many bloods ran cold in my my blood ran cold in my vein. The sands were covered with human bones, the ground red with their blood, half eaten and mangled, mangled pieces of flesh here and there. I counted 3 skulls, 5 hands, and the bones of 3 or 4 legs and a feet. Now, when he told that victim that they don't eat men, when he was searching for them, for the cannibals and their canoes, what he saw that where they were standing, they were sitting and dancing, there were the full ground was covered with blood, and and it was covered with the mangled piece, means half eaten. Mangled piece means the pieces which have been half eaten. The original look of that body had been diminished, had gone. You cannot recognize them or recognize by looking at the piece of those pieces of that mask. So he looked at them, at those mangled pieces, and he started counting. There were 3 skulls. Skulls means the head, right? 5 hands, right? 5 hands eaten, and their bones were bones of 3 to 4 leg pieces of a human body was thrown here and there. Friday was not upset at all. Now, Robinson Crusoe was very upset at that sight, but Friday, he was not upset. He was not feeling or disgusting from inside, right? When he saw those sights. In fact, I saw that he would have eaten the flesh if I let him. But he knew that I would kill him if he did such a thing. So what he analyzed by looking at Friday, that if he was not debarred, like he was not forbidden, he was not being scolded by Robinson Crusoe, Friday would have also eaten those mangled pieces of human body, right? Friday never did so. Why? Because he was scared that if he did, Robinson Crusoe, his master, would kill him. We set to work and buried the bones in the sand. I hope that I would never see such a terrible sight again. Now, what Robinson Crusoe did, he collected all the bones from the beach, and he buried it beneath the sand. And he prayed. Hope means he prayed that he never get a chance to see such sights in his life. That's it, children. I hope this is all for lesson number 6. I hope you must have understood. Go through the stories from chapter 3 to 6. 4 lessons will be coming. 3, 4, 5, 6. Huh? 4 lessons will be coming for your half yearly. Go through it, read it thoroughly and its meaning, and prepare yourself for your exam. I'll be also attaching the PDF along with this video. Please make sure that you write down your answer. Now, children, you know that for your exam for English language we've been asked to tell you that there will be a listening skill. Now your listening skill, and that will be marked for 10 marks, right? So a passage will be read thrice, and you have to listen carefully, and then the question will be given to you, and you are going to write it in a write it and send it to us. So that's it for the day. Have a good day.